that, but I just don't think it does anything.
That would actually be a really good example for you to use with the media and stuff as well.
We're in the community all the time. We've had an enormous amount of anecdotal feedback from people. I've had lots of people come up to me. But we'll be releasing the study this afternoon for you to look at.
The job of rebalancing the economy is not finished. We need considered and consistent change over time.
They'd be a bit interested in, I can see why, it was just around savings.
Yeah.
So he said, oh, you know, you guys have been talking about savings and balances and things.
How we might achieve that? Well, we made some progress in the last budget. What happens from here, we'll come back and tell you in due course. We've had a chance to weigh up the options.
I'm going to take you home to the greatest country in the world.
We welcome foreign investment if it adds value to New Zealand, and I think just on the basis of a sheer purchase of land, I'm not saying we'd stop it, but I'm just saying I don't think it adds a lot of value to New Zealand. To do that, I think we have to take people with us, and we certainly can't take them for granted.
Yesterday you said we were about a year away from an election. Today you said 16 months. Are we heading for an October-November election?
Just thought I'd do it to make your case, actually. But I wouldn't want to speculate on the date today.
Participation.
Thank goodness, that we've got a Minister of Education that is standing up and addressing the
river. Now, we know for the Australians it's because they're lucky, not because they're smart. But in any case, it is good for us.
Cheers, John.
What government can do is ensure that the environment is right for the private sector, for entrepreneurs, for innovators, for those who make the effort to get ahead and do the job that we all benefit from.
I mean, it's easy to forget, but think about the 80,000 families who are living in a leaky home. They sat around for the better part of a decade under a Labor government who weren't prepared to do anything for them. This government stood up, put $1 billion on the table and showed them there was a solution to their problems. I think you can be very proud of that.
I have to say, Mr. President, being Minister of Health is the best job in government. It wasn't actually going very well. We came to office and it was about 9%.
What's the policy about? And the argument here is it's about creating jobs for people that may not get jobs. So there's a lot of people that, in my view, would be locked out of the labour markets without this opportunity.
At the end of August, which is 7 months ahead of schedule, State Highway 20 to 1.
When our party was formed in 1936, it chose the name National because it wanted to be a party that represented all New Zealanders. That's exactly what we are doing.
We've got another full morning this morning. Everybody ready to go?
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome our Prime Minister, John Key, and his wife, Verona.
When our party was formed back in 1936, it chose the name National because it wanted to be a party that represented all New Zealanders. And that is precisely what we are doing. The government got the balance right, and New Zealand is much better for that. Since we came into office, and after years and years of increases, the number of public service bureaucrats has finally gone down. In general, employers have acted responsibly and workers have been treated fairly. So I want to announce today that the government is going to extend the 90-day trial period to cover all employers. In a year's time, we will once again be gearing up to fight an election. We'll be in great shape for that battle. We have a team that we can be proud of, a record we can campaign on, and forward-looking policies that will take New Zealand the next step towards a brighter future. I look forward to that election campaign. Thank you very much.
Came down, broke the door outside and tried to get in.
They said that they would go out and name and shame employers who were bad. Well, I haven't seen anyone named and shamed.
The people that I meet in the street, what they say to me is, I don't care about a probationary period, I care about the fact I don't have a job. Today, we've given them a chance to get a job.
Ham and cheese, by the way.
Hello. So talking more about Sanjay coming to the house last night. Your Pizza Hut delivery man.